In this video, I want to talk about a pattern that a lot of notable people in the space are talking about with Bitcoin. And the point of this is to illustrate potentially a nice downside move or upside. And I want to kind of make a case for both. I was going to upload a video last night. I'll show a little clip here. Never got around to editing and uploading it. But basically, it was about me being very bullish in the short to midterm, but also a part of me thinking that we're going to get a retracement. So we're going to talk about that in this video. If you're new to the channel, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, turn on post notifications, all the good stuff, and we can just jump right into it. Follow me on Twitter as well. So before we get into this pattern, so the bear flag, that's what people are talking about. Two people that I really follow closely. I don't really watch a lot, but I do follow the moon. I follow Sunny Decree. I follow Crown. Alicia Rustani, Crypto Daily, more for entertainment than anything. But those four people are who mainly I follow for information and insight into what they think the market is doing. So I just want to get that out of the way and address that as well. This is the moon on Twitter. He posted this, and Sunny Decree actually posted a video then this morning as well in reaction to this. He directly references it, and he talks about why, well, his video is about why he disagrees with it. So this is a bear flag. So you see the pole flag, and this comes out of a descending pattern here, and it indicates further downside. Bull flag indicates the opposite. This is a bear flag. So this would be the pole, you know, extending down, essentially this line transposed over here. So that's the moon. Follow him on Twitter if you like. He's very good information. Or follow him on YouTube mainly. So here we have the 4 hour and the 1 hour, and I kind of want to do this on the 1 hour. So what we would do essentially is you take the pole here and copy and paste it and kind of just drag it over and put it at the end of the flag there. My flag's not perfect. Let me just kind of change that a little bit. So yeah, and that again indicates a move down to about 10,000. Other people have different charts, but that's what I'm showing on mine. So that actually lines up perfectly with this line that I've had here for weeks. And if we actually zoom out, we can get a better idea of what that line is. Let's actually go to the daily, just so you can see why I had that line drawn in the first place. So the daily here obviously lines up with major resistance during the bear market of 2018. Haven't seen much having to do with that line so far in this bull run. Again, sliced right through it. People did think this was going to be a very difficult area to get through, right around 10,000 right here, right? So again, let's zoom into the smaller time frames, and I just kind of want to take a look at this, talk more about it, because not only, first of all, this isn't playing out exactly right, because it is increasing here, finding support on the 50-day moving average. So I also want to transition this video and talk about a bullish scenario. And this is what the video last night was talking about. So I hadn't got around to posting it, but basically what my point of that video was that I'm very bullish on the space. There's so much momentum. A part of me as well thinks there should be a pullback. Many people agree with that. Many people are saying we should have a pullback, 30, 50% retracement. We haven't gotten one. If we take a look clearly on the daily, you can see we haven't gotten one. Look at this. You guys all familiar with this chart. Just boom, 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 straight up. Just keep going up. No significant pullback. Small ones along the way, but no significant pullback. Sorry, I was in the way of that entire thing. So yeah, you guys are familiar with that chart anyway. Now, the momentum is very strong. Something, you know, I've been in the space for only around 2 years now, but something I do want to share, and I think many of you agree, is that I guess it goes back to the simple saying, if it's too good to be true, it probably is. So basically what I mean by that is usually when we just continuously go up, there eventually is a point where we stop doing that and we have a significant pullback for an extended period of time. Doesn't always happen, but it does very often happen. We haven't seen it yet in the last 3 months of this insane bull rally. However, that doesn't mean it's not going to happen. In fact, the longer that it goes on going up, the more likely and healthy it would be if we had a nice pullback. And again, so I mentioned some TA people that I follow. Something Alicia has been saying in the past few weeks, including his video today, is that it would actually be very bearish if we broke to 14 or 15, maybe even 16 within the next few days, just because it would be so extreme in terms of the exuberance and price increase that it would most likely indicate an even further pullback going into that. And I have perfect evidence of this. Obviously, we had insane gains on June 26th, 20% gains in a day. Bitcoin went from 11,000 to 14,000. But then the following day, we saw an even bigger move down. So this is the candle up. We see an even bigger candle down. So if we would see something, let's, 12,000 to, let's say 16,000 right here. Let's say we had a candle like this. We put in a candle like this. What most likely would happen if we did get something like that, I just want to put this on the screen here, a candle that size, we would probably get a candle the similar size downwards. Maybe the next day, maybe not, but probably soon afterwards. Because the market is so overbought right now, the market is so overextended, that necessarily would not be a good thing. And so if you want $20,000, $30,000 Bitcoin by the end of the year, that would be a worse way of obtaining that. A better way would be to get a pullback now, maybe to 10,000, maybe to 11, maybe even below 10,000, 9,000, maybe at the lowest 8,000. And again, I'm kind of rounding, so maybe, not exactly 8,000, 8,400, 8,500. The point is, a bear flag now would be good long term. Continued uptrend now would be not good. This is my opinion, but this is also the opinion of many people who I follow in this space, and I kind of take in all of their information and try to formulate my own. But for the most part, I think many of them are on the same page as each other, and I agree with a lot of what all of them have to say in terms of this. Now again, we want to look at, on the 4 hour. So this bear flag isn't necessarily playing out, but I would not be surprised, and in fact, I'm kind of expecting a downward move, maybe to the 10,000 area, maybe even all the way down to the 8,000 area. So again, this is what that pattern would look like. We see, let me actually extend this here because I think it would actually go below 10,000. So we have from here the high around right around 14 to where we are now, or to where we hit right around 10,000. So that's a $4,000 move. We copy and paste that percentage drop there, kind of put it at the end of this flag. So right around here, takes us all the way to about 9,000. And again, that keeps 8,000, 8,600, 8,700 in play. So again, these numbers, obviously I'm not gonna put like a 8,761 or something, like a perfect number, because that doesn't make any sense. But roughly around this area. And again, that would break right through the 10K, come down to the 200-day moving average. Again, probably strong support here. So maybe around 94, 9,500 would make sense. But overall, if you guys are in this market, even short term, many of you are in here long term, so this doesn't even apply. Even if you're in here just for short term or midterm trades, this is still kind of the move you would want. You wouldn't necessarily want us to break through and go to 16. That would not be healthy, and that would not be maintainable at all. So that's one scenario. The scenario that the moon and other people in the space, well, actually, I think the moon is the only one I've seen so far who's said this. Maybe other people have. If they have, that's awesome. But a move down to below 10,000 would be ideal. That would be healthy, and I think that long term would make, even midterm and short term, would just make this market a lot healthier. And if we zoom out, would make this trajectory. And look, that even pulls back to the 50-day moving average on the daily chart here. Perfect. That would make sense. Ideally, in a world where TA works, most likely that is exactly what would happen. We have to wait and see, because there's another scenario. That pullback, which I think is healthy. It's kind of contradictory, because a pullback being healthy as opposed to going up being unhealthy. But it does make sense, because say we do go up to the 15, 16. If I take this out on the daily chart, it'll just illustrate why it like wouldn't look as healthy here. Let's say we go up to 16,000 US dollars. 16 right about here. Let's go back. As you can see right here, that was kind of right in the center of kind of where this move stabilized or peaked in 2017. Obviously, I don't count this blow off top right around 20,000. I consider this more of the top right around 17. But then 16 obviously saw some resistance there. So I'm just kind of putting this in the general area. 16, as of right now, is another 33% away. So if we saw another 20% day, Within the next few days, again, I don't necessarily think that would be as healthy. I think we need consolidation. We need a pullback. And I think that's what the moon expects. I think that's a lot of people in this space who are familiar and just understand these charts would say. Again, guys, as I mentioned in my video yesterday, I'm not a professional trader. Never have tried to be, never have claimed to be. I hope anyone doesn't view me that way. I think for the most part, nobody does view me that way. But I do get comments every once in a while being like, oh, you think something about saying how thanks for the technical analysis and good or bad comments about being a technical analysis or analyst. Again, makes me cringe a little bit. I'm very interested in the markets. I love cryptocurrency. I love the idea. I love looking at the price. I love looking at the charts. But I'm not here to give you financial advice, obviously, but I'm here to give you possibilities and just essentially it boils down to my opinion. And my opinion very much aligns with, in this video, Carl, the moon's prediction, or not prediction, his scenario. And also just throwing in some of my own little ideas into it as well. But that's kind of the point of this video and the basis of this video. Guys, that's gonna be it for this video. Let me know what you think. Do you think that a pullback down to the 50-day moving average would be healthy? A nice bear flag setting up. Again, we look on the 4 hour or the 1 hour here. It doesn't necessarily look like it's playing out exactly, but I would not be surprised if we see further momentum down. Overall, the micro trend on these smaller time frames and just in the market in general does potentially indicate some more downward momentum. Macro obviously is just very bullish. Macro is that we're just going to continue to go up and we're enter the bull market or just continue the bull market, continue the bull rally. So guys, that's going to be it for this video. If you're new, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, turn on post notifications. Check out the moon as well. I'm sure many of you already have. He has a lot of subscribers and a lot of views and everything. So, obviously people already watch him. I actually made a video about him a few months ago and it was kind of like a roast video, but essentially it just ended up being like a complimentary video. It just ended up being me kind of like complimenting and saying, oh, it's a good channel. I like that. But yeah, if you guys are new, make sure to leave a like, subscribe. I think I already said that. I'll see you in the next video.